안녕하십니까. 안녕하세요.
안녕하세요.
So, I would like, first of all, I would like to formally welcome you all and formally thank you for coming over to our 10-minute lecture. So, actually, you're here for a very special reason. But before anything else, let me first introduce you myself. My name is John Paul Cordova from the Philippines. Yeah. I will be your lecturer for this special moment. So, by the way, how are you all?
Great.
Are you okay?
Yes.
Okay. Are you okay?
Yes.
Okay. So, today I'm going to lecture a very significant topic, and I hope that you would really listen very well, because I tell you that this topic might help you a lot in your future life and how you're going to live your life in the future. So listen very carefully, okay?
Yes.
Yes. So my topic for this session would be all about the chapter 5, section 3 of the Divine Principle. It's all about the resurrection of Christians, resurrection of religionists, resurrection of evil people.
Yes.
So are you familiar with the word resurrection?
Yes.
What comes into your mind when you hear the word resurrection?
Hope.
Resurrection. It's like coming back to life, right? So actually, we do have a lot of interpretations about resurrection. Many religions have like a different way of interpreting this kind of resurrection. But today we are going to discuss resurrection in a spiritual sense. So at the time of the second advent or the returning Christ, all life spirits who dwell in paradise will return to the people on earth. So clearly, as Christians, we all are waiting for the second coming, right?
Yes.
It's very clear in the Bible that we are waiting for the second coming of Christ. And it says that all life spirits who dwell in paradise, when the second advent will come, will return to the people on earth. Why? Christians will be guided by the spirits from paradise to find the Christ at the second advent and devote their lives to attend the Lord. So this coming of the second advent is very important and very crucial part for those spirits who dwell in already in the spirit world, because this is their opportunity to resurrect themselves. Okay, but how are they going to resurrect themselves? By cooperating with these Christians to fulfill God's will, the spirits can share the same benefit of attaining the divine spirit level and entering the kingdom of heaven. So clearly, by what?
Cooperating.
So these spirits in the spirit world who have not reached perfection will can enter the kingdom of heaven. So clearly there is hope for them. Aju?
Aju!
But this is it. They will cooperate to those Christians who are living here on earth. Okay?
Yes.
And they can share the same benefit of attaining this divine spirit. So we will discuss further how. So Christianity is basically this key to be united. So according to book of Jude, chapter 14, it says, "See, the Lord is coming with thousands upon thousands of His holy ones." As explained previously, all religions are gradually coalescing into one cultural sphere based on Christian ideals. So if you're wondering why you always say a Christian, because Christianity is the chosen
religion
for Christ of the second advent. So at the second coming of Christ, all spirits who believe in religions outside of Christianity will also return to earth. So it's very clear that Christ at the second advent, who is to conquer Christianity, is also the Maitreya Buddha, who is to return for the Buddhists. So, not just Christianity, is the only religion who is waiting for the second coming. Also, other religions of history are also waiting for this perfect man or ideal man who will come to save the world. Like in Buddhists, they are waiting for this Maitreya Buddha. Christ will also be the true man who is awaited in the Chinese religious tradition. So for Chinese, they are waiting for this certain true man. Who would that be? Do you have any idea? We will reveal later.
Yes. Wow.
The returning Christ is the central figure expected in other religions as well. So that's what I said a while ago, that not only Christian religion, but all religion in the history in this world are waiting for that returning Christ. So they will guide their fellow believers on earth to believe in Christ and attend Him in His work. So all these religions will guide their fellow believers on earth to believe the second coming of Christ. And of course, would attend Him in His work. So we can find a parallel example of this at the first advent coming of the Christ. So according to the story, the three wise men from the east, who were Zoroastrians, came in search of Jesus and honored Him at His birth. So are you familiar with this story?
Yes.
Yes, very clear, right?
Yeah.
So spiritual dies from the spirit world. Accordingly, all religions will eventually be united around a revived Christianity. So there is that one new expression of truth that would unite all religions, harmonize all these ideologies and philosophies, and would share the same principles that could relate to one another, and eventually we can attain that world of lasting peace. Aju!
Aju!
So this revived Christianity will teach about the three great blessings. So I believe you are familiar with three great blessings, am I right?
Yes!
The origin of sin, the biblical last days, the purpose of the Messiah, resurrection, the Holy Trinity, and mystery of restoration. So these are really very amazing topics, very interesting. And this is what the revived Christianity will going to teach. Ancient cultures believed in reincarnation. During the Second World War, four-star General Patton believed he was the reincarnation of Alexander the Great. So, there are a lot of movies, right, who are telling, who are sharing our stories about reincarnation. Are you familiar with this reincarnation?
Yes.
Right? You are dead and you have the chance to go back to life to a certain person, right?
Yes.
Since the early people are, in a sense, the second coming of these guiding spirits, they think that they are their reincarnation. The Hindu and Buddhist doctrines of reincarnation interpret these outward impressions, but without knowing the principle of returning resurrection. What about spirit people who in their earthly lifetime led a conscientious life but did not believe in any religion? So what do you think will happen to them? Are there still hope for them?
Yes.
Do you believe?
Yes.
So they will also return to earth to receive the benefit of returning resurrection. So this is there is what we call returning resurrection. They will guide conscientious earthly people to seek out Christ in the second advent. So this explains why you are here. So you are here not just because of your own will or your own capacity, but there are spirits who are pushing you to go here. Do you agree?
Yes!
So they are helping earthly counterparts like us to attend and assist the Lord in fulfilling God's will. Next, let's examine the returning resurrection of evil spirits. In the biblical last days, are you familiar with last days?
Yes.
Evil spirit people will return to evil people on earth on the same spiritual level and assist them to accomplish God's will. It's very clear. To receive the benefit of returning resurrection, heaven allows evil spirit to torment earthly people as punishment for their sins. So this explains why sometimes we feel like there's something pushing us to do something evil, right? So this actually the work of evil spirits trying to push us. And once we can overcome that certain kind of challenge, they too can be resurrected or can gain the same spiritual growth or benefit. Okay? Do you understand?
Yes.
Do you follow?
Yes.
These works of evil spirits may help an earthly person purge his sin in two ways. First, the spirit may trouble the earthly person directly, or the evil spirit may go to the spirit self of another evil person living on earth and work through the second person to attack him. So it's clear, right?
Yes.
If the earthly person gratefully and willingly suffers the work of the evil spirit, he or she can purge sin. Thus, the works of the evil spirit will have cast judgment on a person for his sin on behalf of heaven. And then what will happen? This spirit will receive the same benefit and also enter a higher sphere of benefit. So this is the hope of those spirits who are already in the spirit world. So imagine how many billion spirits are there in the spirit world. There are 108 billion lived on earth before. And how many of them went to heaven? You can imagine there are only a little. And there are many who are still suffering. And there are 7 billion people who live on earth now. So that is why right now we can experience a lot of experiences, a lot of spiritual experiences. It's because they are returning. Because today is the last days, and this is the day in which the second advent of Christ will come. So that's all from the lecture for this moment. I hope you understand everything. Do you?
Yes.
Okay.
So as a reflection regarding the lecture, clearly there is hope, right?
Yes.
So there is still hope for all of our ancestors in the spirit world to be resurrected. And who are their hopes?
We
again, who are their hopes?
We
only if we fulfill our portion of responsibility, then together with our ancestors we can go to
heaven.
Kingdom of
heaven.